Welcome back, guys, to another one. Today, let's have a look at Noctua's first budget-friendly air cooler, the U12S Redux, and that it comes with a secondary fan upgrade kit. And as you can see, budget, this is just like this, because Noctua doesn't know how to downgrade in quality. Usually when it comes to single tower CPU air coolers, most will think of 120 or 92mm heatsink, since it has been in the last decade or so ground zero for a mental picture to what we compare and rate everything. Thus, Noctua has decided to expand their Redux line with their first full sample from this class. This is the U12S Redux, basically a highly affordable U12S which promises all of the key selling points, including the 6 years warranty, excellent RAM, case and PCI compatibility. The Epic SecureFern 2 mounting system is still present, and the heatsink even comes with a pre-applied H1 thermal compound. Then alongside the U12S Redux, they even offer a second fan upgrade kit called the FK1 Redux. Usually upgrading to a push-pull style dual fan setup, this will further improve cooling performance or reduce noise levels by having two fans running at lower speeds because they divide the workflow. Today I will explore both options as well. As for the main attraction, the U12S Redux can be had for just 50 bucks, which is a significant reduction from 80 if you want the U12S Pro Max Black, for example, and even the regular U12S, which costs around 70 bucks. The U12A is a different beast altogether, but this will give you an overall perspective regarding all of the single tower 120mm heatsinks from Noctua. Regarding the second fan upgrade, the FK1 Redux retails for 17 bucks, and it comes with a Y splitter and low noise adapters. Thus you get a lot of cooling potential for around 70 bucks when combined with the U12S Redux. As you would imagine, there would be a different packaging design to keep things obvious that this is the Redux series. A light grey is the theme here with minimal branding. The U12S Redux comes shipped in a smaller box when compared to the regular U12S, for example, a small detail where they cut down the costs. However, it is still very well protected inside. There's no more visual depiction of the actual heatsink, but they still touch on the main highlights. Of course, the mandatory detail spec list is still present. Then the FK1 Redux has an identical presentation to the U12S Redux. Inside, Noctua included two low noise adapters to make sure that if you want to use them, it needs to happen in tandem with the original fan from the heatsink, because they clearly state not to use the LNA on the Y splitter. The grey P12 Redux fans will spin up to 1700 RPM, which is 200 higher than the F12s you would find in the standard U12Ss, and thus will push plenty of air. They are rated over 150,000 hours of continuous operation, the same as every premium fan they sell. The fan has 9 highly optimized airflow blades that use Noctua's signature vortex control notches. Basically, they spread the fan's noise emission over a wider range of frequencies. Then the fans use the first generation of Noctua's amazing SSO hydronomic magnetic bearing rotors, and thus this is another key difference when compared to the regular U12Ss that use the second generation. Finally, the 4-pin PWM cable is a bit short than what we know from the other models, but it's still fully sleeved. The only difference between this fan and the one found in the U12S Redux kit comes in the form of thicker anti-vibration rubber frame pads. These are chunky on purpose because they can absorb more vibration on the exhaust side and thus reduce further noise. Next up, we have the U12S Redux. This time around, the accessory box is not present on the top, but acts as a supporting element for the heatsink packaging. As a custom by Noctua's tradition with attention to details, even this ordinary cardboard that holds the Intel backplate is marked with the designation U12S. Regarding the full list of accessories, here is everything inside the box. Mind you, if this is how Noctua presents a lower budget product, well, I think they have no competition. The heatsink is as premium as any other one from their lineup. The U12S Redux heatsink stands 150mm tall, has a depth of 45mm alone, or 71 with the first fan installed, and 125mm in width. These overall dimensions will ensure that there will be no interferences whatsoever coming from the RAM and PCIe areas. We have 50 aluminium fins that are held into place with the help of 4 nickel-plated heatpipes. One short one compared to the regular U12Ss. There is an extra thicker top plate that has the Redux logo etched next to the access path towards the securing base plate. Speaking of, it's held into place by these 4 Phillips screws, one on each corner. To make things even easier when it comes to the installation process, they even pre-apply the H1 thermal paste in this honeycomb pad. If you wish to remove the paste to apply your own, or further down the line when you remove it from your computer, you will discover that the base plate doesn't have a mirror polish, but the machining process is almost perfect. Then it's obvious that the fan is identical to the one found in the FK1 kit, which I covered earlier. Installation time. Noctua's Secure Firm 2 mounting platform is still present, and from previous experiences, this is one of the easiest and most straightforward installation sequences ever, especially on the AM4 socket. So the first step is to retain the stock motherboard backplate and to remove the plastic front AM4 brackets. Then attach the grey Noctua spacers. The next step is to screw down the metal brackets. Another cool detail from Noctua, they even specified the torque down values. Since the thermal paste is already pre-applied, just attach the heatsink without the fan and bolt it down. Install the fan to the heatsink and connect it to the motherboard. It's easy to see that there is no interferences of any sort in any direction, even on my ITX board. Now this is how it looks with a second fan attached. Don't forget to use the included wire adapter if your motherboard doesn't have multiple CPU fan ports. I'm still using my good old Ryzen 7 1700 CPU, which I will overclock to 1.325V and test the U12S Redux in both the single and dual fan setup, of course. Let's start in order of CPU low difficulty. First up is the Cinebench R15 test. On the left we have the CPU in stock form, while in the middle we have it overclocked, and both scenarios are for the one fan configuration. The third picture has the overclock scenario with the second fan attached. Be mindful of the low ambient temperatures, and we notice that the U12S Redux in its stock form performs as expected and empirically beats the regular U12S just because its fan will spin a bit higher. However, in the dual fan configuration, the U12S Redux has an additional headroom by about 3 degrees Celsius. The Cinebench R20 test puts more load on the CPU, and thus we should see even higher temps. The overall rankings are preserved, but this time the delta for the dual fan setup revolves at around 2 degrees Celsius. In ADA64 we isolate the stress test just for the CPU, therefore we should get the highest stress scenario for the chip, but sometimes we get mixed results where the R20 will push the CPU further than ADA in terms of heat output. Nothing changes from the previous test, and we get again excellent results in the dual fan mode. Gaming-wise, Rise of the Tomb Raider isn't as stressful as a synthetic torture test, but a great indicator of real-life usage. As you can see, we get really good results here. Now for the noise tests, here are some quick sound samples with the full system running for both fan scenarios. Despite its overall higher RPM, the P12 Redux fans are still very quiet even in the higher RPM range. Now the best thing here is that in the dual fan mode on Oro fan curve, both fans will spin lower because they are dividing the workload. Suffice to say, the U12S Redux in both single and dual fan mode will provide an overall quiet acoustic experience, as we are already accustomed by Noctua products. Well, there you have it guys, when most companies downscale their products to make sure that they meet specific price targets, the overall quality usually suffers. Noctua not only avoided that, but even created something that instantly becomes a best buy. It's like they don't know how to fail or to downgrade in quality, that's why their brand is synonymous with quality among many other things. The U12S Redux is most definitely a must have for anyone who wants all of the Noctua hallmarks, build quality, cooling and noise performance at a very attractive price level. backed by 6 years warranty and the sheer fact that for the price of one regular U12S you can have both the U12S Redux and the FK1 upgrade package, well, that is definitely a no-brainer. Thank you for watching, guys, and until the next one, Alex out.